Bam! We're live. It's live? Like recorded live?
All right. Recording, man. We're live out here.
We're live out here in the streets. Yeah. So listen, I appreciate you guys watching us and listening and following us. The Brothers Who Talk. I'm AD. This is Terry. Oh, so we are on a race to 100 subscribers. 100 subscribers. And I definitely want you to be a part of that. And as a gift, once we reach 100 subscriptions, we will be giving away an Amazon gift card. An Amazon gift card. So get in on this. Get in on this and be a part of our 100 subscribers. We love you guys. We appreciate all the support. We are growing rapidly, and we want you to be in on this. So as a congratulations and a thank you for following us, you know, and sharing in our journey, we're going to be giving away a gift card, as well as make sure you have any of your podcast apps. Make sure you listen to the Brothers Who Talk. Support, rate, comment. Let us know what you think. Even if you don't like us, let us know. If you're watching this YouTube, give us a thumbs down. It's all good. I don't mind.
You know, I want to sign language so bad. But I don't know how to sign, and I don't want to be defensive to anybody, so we're not gonna do that. But like you said,
right?
Like you said,
yes.
Race to 100.
Yes.
Amazon gift card.
Yes.
The raffles. Don't miss out. I'm telling you.
Don't miss out. All right. Okay. That's it. That's all.
Welcome to another episode of the Brothers Who Talk.
Brothers Who Talk
with Terry and AD. This podcast is about men talking about everyday shenanigans, the stuff that makes us mad, to the topics that concern why in the world do these guys have a podcast. Let's get to it.
So yeah,
we
haven't fixed that yet. All right.
Someone need to call the technical department. Technical department.
No, we're gonna call. Welcome back, you guys, to the Brothers Who Talk live stream podcast. Happy Friday Junior to you. So
yes,
those of you guys that haven't been following us for a while, Friday Junior is Thursday. So happy Thursday to you. So we're gonna start it off like we do every episode. AD, how was your week, good sir?
All right, finish sharing. My week. It's been good. We are planning our kind of impromptu wedding ceremony. The fifth on that Sunday. So we are in the process. You will get the pictures of how we put up the tent. Me, my wife, and the children. We're kind of hooking. This is a family affair. So this is going to be very, very interesting. So this is how my week is going. Dealing with that, cutting down some tree limbs and stuff like that that's overhanging. So this is going to be fun. This is going to be some live stream moments that you guys will be able to witness.
All right. This would not be on the Patreon.
Right. So definitely appreciate the week, and it's going to be amazing next week. Yeah. So if you would like to come, don't come. Just send your gifts and money. Thanks. Appreciate you.
You gotta put that cash app up, bro.
Andy Walker helps. Dollar sign.
So, and keeping in the spirit of how was everybody's week, my week was quiet because the family is still gone. They are pulling out tomorrow from Illinois, so they'll be road tripping back to Idaho. They should be here by late Saturday, early Sunday. I can't wait to see them and fuss at them and all that. So I kind of miss it. I kind of miss fussing at them. I really do. Not sure why. Right. But that's been my week so far. Let's see. I'm kind of boring. A little boring life, AD. I don't really do anything.
Work and broadcast and
if I'm not in front of my Mac, right, I ain't doing nothing. I'm in here, you know. I'm telling you what I'm figuring out. What I'm figuring out is, after you break a limb or a finger or something,
okay,
getting your finger back to normal is hard work, right?
Therapeutic.
If you guys have been watching us for a while, Brothers of Legacy, Brothers of Talk, and you see me or brunching, and you saw me in a red cast or a black cast,
right?
When I had broke my thumb, and now that I have had my cast removed for a full week, my finger I still can't grip. you know, cups. So when I go to the drive-thru, which I've done a lot of since the family been gone, I can't grab the, I have to grab the cup from with both hands out of the window.
Because the thumb not used to working.
Yeah, yeah. I was only in there for 6 weeks, man. I mean, it's not like it's...
It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Thumb's on break, on vacation. They said, you know what? We got to go back to work.
I don't know. I don't know. All right, so you guys, this is how we're going to do it. If you've been watching for the last couple of weeks or so, we have a new segment called The Top 5. And what I read to you guys is top five of the dumbest articles that's ever been written. I don't know what you're supposed to think about. So hang tight. We'll do top five real quick. All right, welcome to the top five. We back.
Top five.
And I'm like, what in the world? Some.
Yes, indeed. Top five. Let's talk.
What? five of these. I feel like Stewie when I said that. What? So, I got some coming. Top five. Hey, that's top. Let's do it. So, the first article in the top five this week is really dumb. And it says, China may be using the sea to hide its submarines.
Choop, 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 choop.
Crickets. You want to know why it's crickets? Because of where submarines go. In the sea. And so, I don't understand that. And this is, these are real articles. Just to give you guys a disclaimer, these are real articles that, this is from an Asian newspaper. It says China may be using the sea to hide its submarines. That's not common sense. I don't know what it is. All right.
Awesome.
Number two, real quick. Federal agents raid a gun shop. Guess what they find?
Guns.
Weapons. Yes.
Wow. Wow. Amazing. Man, I guessed that. See how smart I am? I figured that out. I figured that out.
Federal agents raid a gun shop and find weapons. That's what they're supposed to find. All right, number three, real quick. Princess Diana was still alive hours before she died. I want everybody who's listening right now on Charm City, Periscope, Facebook, I want you guys to let that sizzle in your spirit just for a second. Diana was still alive.
You're dropping nuggets this morning. Good morning, Melissa. You're dropping nuggets.
I'm telling you, Diana was still alive hours before she died. You know what? I can't.
I'm sorry, guys. I know you're probably like, this is not funny.
This is not funny. Yes, it is. It's hilarious. Right. If you think about it, it's still alive before she dies.
What's the next nugget?
Oh, man. Okay, it's another one. This is from the Daily Sun. I'm not sure which year it is, but it said the article is man kills himself and then runs away. Let that sizzle. Think about it. He kills himself first. And then runs away. Who writes this stuff? That's what I want to know. Where? I need help. Somebody like the as if like.
Oh man,
you can't make this stuff up. This is like real stuff. This is printed. He killed us. Can you imagine?
Ooh, blessings, success to you as well, Dr. Hata.
Kills himself and then runs away. Wow. Hey, my love, I saw this dude. All right, here's the last one. I think it's the last one. What number is it? Oh, I got one more after this one.
One more. All right.
A nuclear explosion would be a disaster. Well, a nuclear explosion would be a disaster. What do you think about that?
Maybe not.
Yeah, it would. I mean, you look at Chernobyl. Remember Chernobyl a couple years ago?
Right.
A nuclear explosion would be a disaster.
Right.
Okay, I need for whoever wrote this to take several seats. This was an article that was written back in May 3rd of 2006.
What's up, Lise?
Just so you know. Yeah. Just so you know. All right. Last one.
Oh, last one. We got one more. Number five.
Number five. Top five right here. World Bank says the poor need more money.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah, you might be right about that.
World Bank says the poor need more money.
Mic drop.
It's a mic drop, dummy. This was back Monday, April 27th of 2009.
Give him cake. Give him cake.
And I want and the author, her name was Deb Reichman. And I want to find her. I'm going to find her on Facebook. And I'm going to be like, what are you thinking? What was that about? You know, so World Bank says the poor need more money. And that, you guys, is your top five, man. I don't know what you folks think about. But a little bit of funny before we get into our thing today. But I hope you enjoyed it. That top five was something this week, man.
Top five.
I tell you, I don't know. Hey, Rhonda, how you guys doing? Dr. G in the building. What's up, man? Dr. G, I haven't seen you. What's up? Hey, Lise. Look a little AD. Man, don't you look pissed off, Lise? You look pissed off. All right. So before we get into our thing, we have to do our branding and our commercial ad. Yes. So I want you guys to hang tight. If you have not yet, this is your opportunity to share the broadcast out. Share on your timeline on Twitter, on Periscope. And we'll be right back. Hold on 1 second. Oh, you caught me drinking. Sorry. I'm back. All right. So welcome back to this episode. Listen, if you don't know where you are, and if you are lost in the sauce a little bit, this is a Brothers Who Talk live stream podcast. This will be available for audio on tomorrow or either Saturday.
Yes.
And what we do here at Brothers Who Talk is we try to give you guys motivation. We always talk about crazy stuff. Yes. We give you top five news articles just because we love to do what we do.
Yes.
All right. But there is a method to our madness, because people don't podcast just because we want to look good and talk to y'all all day.
Yes.
Right. There's a reason for it. But what we want to do today is we want to talk about how we got started on the Buzz Who Talk and this whole live streaming journey. Because the thing of it that we realize is that there are people who want to get on here and tell their story. But they don't know how to get started, right?
Right.
So the topic for today is, this is how we do it. We'll teach you for a nominal fee. So, AD, man, look, see, when we think about how we got started and how the Buzz of Legacy came about, and then how the Buzz Who Talk was spawned, does it rack your brain when you think about where we started from to where we are now?
A little bit. Because, you know, before then there was no screens in the back, headphones, mics. There was, for me, it was just this.
Yeah, that's all. Yeah.
That's it. Like this.
Yeah.
and we kind of wanted to share just, you know, a little inspiration for those that are starting. You know, you start where you at. Wherever you're at, just get started. You know, you have your phone and you'll start looking up and seeing studios and stuff, but don't worry about just purchasing a bunch of things and items and mics and stuff like that. And there's so many things. There's so many devices. There's so many platforms to broadcast from. You would rack your brain. So just find something that you're comfortable with and start right there and grow. You know, then get a mic, then get a headphones. And, you know, the thing that I've learned it's not necessarily about the equipment you have, it's the content that you possess. So when you start, you know, what are you talking about and what message are you trying to deliver? For me, when I started over, like 4 years ago, I feel like almost five, it was about just inspiring, inspiration, encouraging. And, you know, when you start, it's okay. The mindset is to get on and to get off, to get on and to get off. It's like, you just got to get through. Right. Number one, tell your story. So whatever your story is, that you're trying to share, that's the main thing. Get focused on the content that you want to deliver. You know, don't get too focused on the how things are going to look, you know, other than watching your live stream and your dog scratching while you're trying to talk.
She be doing it, boy.
Content is king. But yeah, you have to, what are you talking about? What's your purpose for being here? Who are you trying to inspire? What are you trying to change? And, you know, if you're trying to sell something, will it relate to the people that are watching you? Because, you know, you're going to watch, and if you have to interrelate whatever it is that you're trying to sell, because you might have a service you're selling, but it has to relate to the story that you're sharing and the content that you're giving, you know, because you're not an advertisement, you're right. Marketing, you know, so you're marketing who you are and you're just delivering. And some people not even selling anything in the beginning, they're just sharing their story. So that's the first thing, tell your story. So for you, Terry, what was it like telling your story?
I remember when I first did, I used to be on this platform called Be Live TV. I don't even know what Be Live TV is still about, but Be Live was, I think Be Live TV and Live and StreamYard was a competition. This is when StreamYard first started out. And I remember telling my story, and I remember being scared out of my mind because I didn't want nobody to know my business. It's my business, you know what I'm saying? But I remember I used to do shows. I used to do my little show in my basement on my phone. On my tripod, downstairs in my basement, and I used to try to give advice because, like Pastor Brian always says, you know, when I talk about stuff or give advice, I don't talk about what I think. I teach what I've lived, yeah, and that's what telling your story is all about. Because somebody's watching this, or will watch this, and they're going to say, you know what, I do have a story to tell. I have been someplace. I have been hurt. I have been molested. I have been whatever your story is.
Right.
Trust it when people say you're not alone in this. Right. It's true. You're not alone. And somebody else's breakthrough is waiting for you. Somebody's waiting to hear that you did it. So right. Always tell your story, you know, and I told my story in 10 parts.
Mm.
I don't know if you remember that Knucklehead Chronicles. That's story in 10 parts.
Right. Oh man,
it's a very interesting story.
Yeah, good. It's good.
It's a very interesting story. So don't be afraid to tell your story.
Right.
And me and this guy got together. We started out Brothers of Legacy.
Brothers United. Wait.
Oh yeah, we had we've gone through so many names, bro. It's not even funny. But it was Brothers United.
Yeah.
And then we switched over to Brothers of Legacy because the Brothers of Legacy had a different connotation,
right.
And we didn't want to be attached to that, so we went to Brothers of Legacy. So don't, number one, do not be afraid to tell your story.
Right.
That's number one. Number two for you, AD.
Don't be afraid to change. So what I mean, like our name, don't be afraid to change based on your evolution. Don't be afraid to show that you're evolving with your story, because sometimes, you know, where you are, where you were 5 years ago is not the same place you are now. Mm-hmm. So don't be afraid to change, you know, even if you meant like, you know what, I evolved in certain areas, I evolved on certain topics, I evolved in certain subjects. You know, like I was the time is money, but then you realize, you know, time has a value on its own. You know, it's things that you from studying, reading and watching, you learn new things, like just growing in life period. You know, we know you have one thought about children till you have them.
Right. Like, exactly.
If I had kids, my kid would never ever do
and that. Then you have them, then it's like a whole different. Yeah.
It's funny. I remember me and my wife, we talked, it was like, we are always going to, if our children ask us why, we're going to tell them. We're going to have a discussion. Now, neither of us grew up like that. We're going to have a discussion about maybe a week into that. Like, because I said so.
Don't do as I do. Do as I say.
You know, so could you spell it? You find yourself going down a rabbit hole of why? Okay, why? Okay, why? So like I said, you evolve. Don't be afraid to change. Don't be afraid to share the next part of your story. Right. You know, that vulnerability is key. You know, people spot fake. You know, people spot fake. You know, and they might follow you for a little while, but then they're like, yo, this dude, they fake. They're not real. You know, so be real about who you are. Be as authentic as you can be online, you know, with sharing things. Because sometimes you're not prepared to share everything. You know, it takes time. For myself, it took me a while to really share my story.
He ain't lying.
It took me a while. And you know, because the first thing, you're truthful with yourself, and then you're looking in the mirror, and then you're like, okay, and then get comfortable with uncomfortable,
right?
So you just have to be willing to share, you know, what's inside of you and what's going on, and be vulnerable, because the vulnerability is in the comments. You know, people are going to ask questions, people are going to say things, and you know, and you just have to be willing to stand. And if you really want to push this live stream thing, you really have to be willing to answer the questions that are difficult. The toughest part of my journey is even starting Purposeful Forever with my wife, because we've been through things, and you know, I wasn't the best dude. So it's admitting, like, yeah, I done jacked some things up, you know, I got this wrong, and being willing to admit those, as well as any current
situations
that, you know, like, oh, you know, and I already had to admit I'm wrong. Then I got to admit it wrong again. Then explain to you guys what I did wrong, right, you know, and where I went left on this thing. So that is the willingness to be vulnerable, be willing to broadcast with the dogs. I know, Chris. I'm sorry, guys. All right. Terry, what's you?
Yeah. So to piggyback off what AD said, man, listen, don't be afraid to change, because doing this live stream, this live stream thing, and at first for me it was just a habit, it was just something to do to pass time, and then once people started listening, and I started receiving inboxes from people, and it's like, you know, Terry, you helped me through a rough spot, and you know, all this, and when you start getting those, you now have to evolve. Now you have to make a decision at that point: am I going to keep doing this for sport? Am I going to do this am I in this to really help people? So it makes you reevaluate. So when you're telling your story, be like AD said, be as honest and as real as you possibly can be, because people can spot fake. And then besides people spotting fake, how long can you be fake before it gets tiring to you? You're like, well, I'm tired doing this. And then next thing you know, then you start skipping out. You have a certain time slot that you do. Like I used to do Fridays at 6 p.m. Mountain Standard. So for me, that was 6 o'clock. For you guys, it was 8 on the East Coast. And then it would be 7 in Central. And I used to go downstairs religiously every Friday and set my stuff up and do my show. And so I had a following at that point. But then I realized I had some stuff I still had to work on.
Right.
And I said, let me quit. And so then I start skipping days. And people were like, Tay, where you been? Where you know what happened?
Right.
And so I lost all of my following because I wasn't done working on myself. So when it comes to being honest and being truthful, this live streaming game, man, is nothing to play with, because people will call you out, and this stuff stays on internet forever. You guys watch the internet. You guys watch the internet. People screenshotting stuff all the time, you know. And if you ain't real, if you say something as contradictory to what you said, I mean, you're gonna be, you know, out the flow with God. Oh, thanks, Chris. And we've had our things, bro. I mean, it ain't always been peaches and herbs over here. It's been tough.
Peaches and herbs. So the next thing I would say is be consistent. And Terry got to that when he was saying going to his basement. You know, being consistent is kind of like clocking in. You know, you clock into a job that you expected to go to, that same expectation you have with going live. So for myself, it was a 7:30. I would, you know, get out, I'd put the kids on the bus, and I'd turn my phone on. From the walk from the bus stop to the house, I would go live. And it's not far. It ain't that far. But right. It was my push to be consistent. It was my push to put out content consistently, because you do build an audience. And what happens, because I did the same, my reasoning, it just, life began to change, and I didn't have the same time slot that I could, and I stopped, you know, and I had momentum going. So when you start, you get momentum. People coming in, you learning, because all the people that we spoke to, for me at least anyway, are people I met here.
Yeah.
not in real life. Pastor McCoy is the only guy is I've known in real life, and then we got online together. Even Terry was here. We've never been in the same place. Yes.
So that means we're Batman,
right?
Everything, yeah. <It's so silly. laughs>
But yeah, that consistency helps. It helps build momentum in your live streams, as well as it helps you show up. You know, when you get so caught up in just yourself and your content and what you're going to put out, and not thinking about the people you're serving, you know, you could lose that momentum. You know, you got to. I'm gonna have another part, so let me not go into my next point. You know, like, let it flood together. Let's do stay on consistency. So that consistency really matters, right, Terry? What about you and your consistency? How do you feel?
I would. Hey, man, consistency is important in this live streaming game.
Right.
That's why I say a little while ago, if you are going to just do this for sport, this is something for you to do, and you don't really care about helping people or whatever your goal is, if you really don't care, then consistency is not going to be an issue for you. But if you are trying to build something, if you are trying to monetize, let's be honest, you guys, when we're doing podcasts and live streams, this stuff ain't cheap. This stuff that you see, right. You know, this mic right here, this one right here, not cheap. The Mac that I'm on, right. The computers I'm on, not cheap. When the programs that we use,
right.
Not cheap. Even StreamYard that we use is not cheap. So if you're in it for real, you got to understand that you're going to have to kind of, you know, put out a little bit of change in order for you to get to build something.
Right.
But don't be afraid of that.
Right.
Right. Because if you, even if when you get your following, people will help you because they want to continue to hear what you got to say.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's why they have Patreon. That's the reason why they have Cash App. That's the reason why they have Venmo. You know right. what I'm saying? Because it's just like if you wanted to help out the Buzz Who Talk, you want to donate to the Buzz Who Talk. There's a Cash App for that.
Right.
You know, if you want to help out the Buzz Who Legacy, there's a Cash App for that. If you want to, it's just like how churches are now, to where you only can give like a virtual. There's a Cash App for that. And so it's the same thing.
All right.
So don't be consistent. Be consistent. Stay in your consistency. Hey, what's up, cuz? Be consistent, because you will lose an audience quick if you're not consistent. Right. I remember back when I was on Periscope, and I got my first cosign from Janine Cummings. And I went live after I got the cosign, and I had 500 people in that scope.
Wow.
That came from all about. They came from everywhere. I don't know where it came from. I just went like, so and then, but I wasn't consistent. I couldn't keep them.
Wow.
But I got, don't take yourself too seriously. I'll be afraid to make mistakes. Exactly. That's a good one.
Right.
Don't take yourself seriously. I mean, we ain't perfect around this joint. You hear me talk, I stumble and stutter.
Right.
But right. I still tell my story, and people think I'm still funny, and that's like, that's cool. I like that.
Right.
But when I slow it down and I'm serious, and then people are like, oh, okay, Terry got something to say. He's going to slow it down a little bit.
Right.
People come to see me because they know what I'm going to say. They know I'm going to say something crazy.
Right.
In a good way. You know what I'm saying? I'm not the author of confusion or nothing like that. But, you know, people come to see me because they know I'm crazy. So like Chris said, don't be afraid to be you. Be you.
Right.
I mean, because you think about this. if you guys troll Facebook like I do, there are people that go live, and they have absolutely nothing to say.
Right.
And they just as ghetto. you know, hey, if you ghetto, that's I'm not knocking ghetto.
Not against ghetto.
But come on, they have absolutely nothing to say.
Right.
And they got followings.
Right. Oh yeah.
Because people love drama.
Yeah.
So they go this, that, stuff. So don't be you. One of the things that, and he's going to piggyback on this. One other thing that we live by is that do it for that one person.
Oh, yeah.
Do it for that one person. Because listen, you're not going to get, it's just like when we started out with Brothers of Legacy. Hey, Lala.
Hey, you know, Lala.
We started out with Brothers of Legacy. We had two people.
Right.
In the podcast, right? And now over the past year and a half, we've grown. We have a little bit of an audience,
right?
But then and them same first two
are still there,
right? You know what I'm saying? So do it for the one person, because you never know,
right,
who's listening and watching. And keep in mind too that there's a thing called replay,
right?
So they might not catch you live,
right?
But they can always go back and catch, like, ooh, I missed that,
right.
Sunday, come on, you know, and so that's how you do it too. So be consistent.
Yes.
Do it for the one,
right?
And don't be afraid to be you.
Right.
I bet you if we had Lala on here, she'll tell you when she first started.
Yeah. Keep pressing forward. Right. Definitely. I'm a Brothers of Legacy OG. I know that's right, Chris.
OG. When we first started out the joint,
yeah.
You know, and Lala, even though Lala has now has a following, she's the Realty Goddess of LA. She has a following, but it wasn't always that way.
Right.
Yeah. People have been listening all the time. They follow you. Like, oh, okay. Then.
Right.
What was last week's show?
Right.
Go back and follow. And that's kind of how they do.
Right.
So yeah, be consistent. Man. That's the best thing.
Just as you're growing and you're putting out, keep in mind, of course, there's always content. So number four would be like content building, and the ways to build your content. So there are several. Of course, you're always talking about your life and things you're dealing with, but also talk about what you've learned, what you've grown from, what you've read that's caught your eye, what you watched. You know, I started one or two people who ended up staying on, and right, exactly. So just Don't get so caught up in the weeds of content that you don't go live, right? Was it analysis of paralysis? You know, you're analyzing so hard that you get paralyzed and you're trying to make things perfect, right? Trying to make things great. And keep this in mind as well. Don't get caught up in the numbers from your last live or the live before that. Like, oh, I had 300 people in there. Let me see if I get 300 again, you know, because then it will keep you down if the next time you come on and you only get 30 or you only get 20. So don't get so caught up in numbers that it paralyzes your content, paralyzes your broadcast. You just get out there. So you hope for the best every time you come out. Like we said, do it for the one. And we had to get into that mindset too, because we have our ups and downs. We killed it. Oh, ain't nobody there. Oh, yeah. We killing it. Oh, ain't nobody there. So we had to get to the mantra. Like, if we focused so much on the numbers, we would have been out of this game way back. way back.
let me give y'all a little bit of context. We used to do Buzz the Legacy.
Yes.
And we had nobody come through. We spent 35, 40 minutes on the broadcast.
We was there.
Not one soul coming.
I was there for him. He was there for me.
We each other's audience, and it was like,
right. Did I post it? Did I share this? Am I on the right profile?
Are we live right now? We hit the record button. So it's, you know, you have to do it. And now a place like Periscope is where I started of live streaming. And Periscope used to be really bad with trolls, right? So, and if you don't know what a troll is, those trolls, they used to come in
You all right? You got to make you got steps? You got steps?
Oh, no, no. No, I got takes from work. I'm not going to work. They want me to come in. I ain't going. Sorry. I asked for the deal. I don't care. So Periscope used to be full of trolls, right? So if you did a broadcast on Periscope, and if you left your broadcast open or didn't, your location, it's not your location or something.
Right.
You get people from around the country that you don't even know.
Right.
They'll be in your stuff. They'll call you ugly.
Oh, yeah.
I remember my first podcast, my first Periscope, and somebody came on and said, your teeth jacked up. And I was like, I've known that for 32 years. You're not hurting my feelings. You know what I'm saying? So it was just that. And so you have people like that. And so people like that, their jobs are to discourage you.
Sorry, this bug is just like right there.
When you do the radio, when you do the audio edit, put in the quiet chop, the quiet sound right there. So, yeah. And so people, their jobs are to make you feel inferior.
Right.
So you'll stop broadcasting, stop coming
to court. I feel like they want you to stop because they can't, they don't have the courage to do it.
Yeah, they don't have the courage to do it. And they keyboard thugs behind the right. keyboard, and it's really crazy how they do that.
So that'll be number five.
Keep it going.
Deal with the trolls.
Deal with them trolls, man. I'm telling you.
And I come to realize there are.
I hope you do the karate chop on that one. I'm just for the karate chop on the edit. I promise.
What? Why? Yo, why are bugs always like break these? Like I'm getting ya. I'm getting ya, ball. Okay. So number five would be dealing with the trolls. They're the known trolls and they're unknown trolls. Now, what are the known trolls? Known trolls are folks that you know that just try to say stuff to throw you off. Mm-hmm. You know, they ask odd questions. You know, you. It take a while usually to get there because then they get bold and say stuff like, because I've had people like that were cool and then one day they just went left on you. They went left on me and I had to block them. Like, really? Like I thought, you know, we were cool. And sometimes you'll get them in controversial issues. You know, like if you're talking about police brutality, defund the police or something, or Black Lives Matter. Like, you know, these are the times where people you know will come out the woodworks and say some off the wall stuff. And it's cool to have a debate or, you know, a conversation, but sometimes when you start hitting with names and, you know, just trying to insult you, that becomes a problem.
Right.
Okay. So that
you know what? Let's do one more commercial, then we're gonna come back and close it out. We back. So, you know, while we're talking about live streaming, I want to take, I hope Lala's still here. Lala, if you're still here, put a comment in, put a one in the comments if you're still here, Lala, because I want to tell this story real quick. Because people are weird, right? They love some of the weirdest stuff.
Uh-oh.
Right?
Uh-oh.
Lala used to run. Yeah. Lala used to run with a group called, I forgot the name now, with Jimmy.
Perry Girls?
No, well, yeah, remember Perry Girls, but she also ran with the Thunder Crew with JSS Scope and all that. And so she would always do the end broadcast or the anchor. She would close the shows out most of the time. So one day we were watching Lala do her thing. And Lala is a singer. Those of you guys who don't know, if you have not watched her and her husband Will's video, we got so far to go. It's that last video they did. In observance dedicated to Black Lives Matter. It's a great video. If you haven't seen it's on my Facebook page, go check that out. They did 95% of that video on iPhone Pro Maxes, just so you know. So it's pretty good stuff. But anyway, so Lala, she's doing her thing, and she says, you know, I'm gonna do something different, right? It just goes to show how stuff can go up and down on social media, right? She turn her camera to her toes because she had said I just got a pedicure. And so people, because she had fans and people want to see, let's see what color your toes are. And she went from like 56 people to like 180 people within 30 seconds. Because we want to see our toes. It's just crazy. So I say that to say this, is don't be afraid to be a little silly.
Right.
You know, and even though she was doing that just to be, you know, to show people her pedicure, right, it just goes to show how social media works.
Right.
Right? So don't be afraid to do any of that. Like I said, go back over to five, you know, dealing with trolls, because you're going to get those. You're going to get those, whether you do it on Periscope, whether you're on Facebook, even your own friends will troll you. And be like, Why are you doing this? Why are you on it?
Right.
You know, right. So be mindful of all that. Be consistent. Do it for the one.
Right.
And
but don't worry about the trolls. Just do it.
Yeah.
Take it from my
good friend Dupay Alaru.
Yes.
When you get those trolls, don't delete none of them. I mean, that's the first thing you want to do. Periscope used to be a thing where we got the block ministry on.
Right.
Don't let them trolls right. Let them trolls hear what you gotta say.
Right.
Because the same folks that you're trying to tell your story to,
right,
them trolls the one they want to hear it.
Right.
They're just trying to be hard butts, you know. So just be consistent and tell your story. That whatever that fly is, he really getting you right.
Yes, now. He is.
Yeah.
I'm gonna catch you like Mr. Miyagi.
Yeah. I used to catch flies out. I used to do that. But you have anything else, Eddie? What we got here?
No, I think that's it. Oh, yeah. Listen, just as you're building, as you're growing.
Hello.
There's a lot of great. Hey, for humanity. There's a lot of great programs to use. So if you have any questions or need some advice, inboxes, hit us up. We can send you the right way. You can get some of the programs and stuff like that. We got some affiliate links and stuff like that. So of course we would definitely tell you what we use. So he said we'll teach you for a nominal fee.
For a nominal fee. You go to you a nominal fee. But well, yeah, hey, welcome to the yard, I tell you. So there are so many different programs, like AD said, there's so many different programs that we use. I personally use StreamYard. We use StreamYard for Buzz of Legacy, Buzz of Talk. I personally use Ecamm because I have an Apple computer, which is the same thing. That's right. He does have a MacBook Pro.
Yes.
So, you know, you can use programs like Restream that if you want to stream on YouTube, Periscope, Facebook, all that at one time, that is a good program to use.
Right.
It's so many different ones. Right. But like I said, and rolling back to the topic.
Now we do.
This is how we do it.
For a nominal fee.
You know what I'm saying? I don't charge about an hour, but I do throw the Cash App out there and they'll take donations. I'm just saying, this is, you know, I was teaching a young lady to use StreamYard just the other day. And I gave her my referral link and I was like, hey, this is how you do it. And she had a little bit of a hard time, it's a struggle. So if you're not tech savvy, I'm going to charge you folks because it's hard. Just saying.
We learned through trial and error. We bumped that a lot through this. So I'm just letting you know. That's why we're kind of hard at this. We didn't go to some school. We didn't. We just hard knocks here. Hard knocks. We got hard it right. Knock. We got it right. Got to connect. Make it look right. Look, we're flowing. Like before we like. But you know,
yeah,
a lot of that. So it was to get to that phase too.
Yeah, like that. But speaking of, let me get these shout outs real shout quick. Out. StreamYard, Charm City Direct TV. I know E Digger's here, but shout out to E Digger, who's the CEO of Charm City, who has allowed us this platform to use. Brothers who talk, we really appreciate you. We want to shout out to Gage Vadentop, who is the CEO of StreamYard. So if you ever decide to get on StreamYard, hit me up on the inbox. I'll throw you my referral link. When Gage first started out with StreamYard, it was small. Now everybody's using StreamYard.
Right.
So he only answer my messages no more. Yeah.
Busy CEO, brother.
But yeah, that's how we do it.
Right.
So I just want to say thank you guys for listening and showing up and being the awesome parents you are. I mean, not parents, the awesome people you are. I hope you enjoy top five.
Yes.
That's going to be.
If you haven't heard it, make sure you go to YouTube.
Run it back. Yeah, run it back. You want to watch top five again, run it back. But you guys have a great rest of your day.
Yes.
Have an awesome weekend, and we'll see you guys next week. All right. Peace.
Thank you for watching and listening to the Brothers Who Talk.
Brothers Who Talk
with Terry and AD. Check us out again next week, where we bring you a steaming helping of common sense, laughs, and advice. We can be found on any podcasting platform, iTunes, Spotify, and iHeartRadio. We're also on MileHighRadio.com, Saturdays at 12 Eastern. See you there.
It's on like a wash machine in the background. I'm not sure.
Oh, you know what?
That's my printing plant. Let me cut that off.
Oh, yeah. Boy, you never know what you're going to get into when you come up in here. I can promise you that. So, love this guy. He's always in doing something. I don't know. All right. So, man, those of you guys
come in. We'll print some t-shirts later. Hold the presses, guys. Thanks.